Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fire.
Okay, here we go, pussycats. This week we celebrate Tura Satana's birthday. I'm sure many of you have tried our Tura coffee not even knowing who Tura is. Well, like your coffee, she's dark, sweet, and too hot for you. For those who don't recognize Tura's name, you might recognize the Russ Meyer's movie Faster Pussycat Kill Kill. You know, the buxom brunette with the bangs, black leather jacket, black hair, she's kicking everybody's ass and driving sports cars across the desert. That's Tura. You know the band Faster Pussycat? That's where they got their name. White Zombie fans, you might recognize some of the samples from Thunder Kiss 65, as well as in Black Sunshine.
I never try anything. I just do it. Like, I don't beat clocks. Just people. Wanna try me?
Thunder Kiss video actually borrows a lot from the film Faster Pussycat Kill Kill. So why did we pick Tura to be our very first signature coffee? Well, Tura is the original badass black-haired, leather-clad Batgirl. She comes from a long line of, like, you know, hard bangs, black-haired chicks like Betty Page, Vampyra, and Tura comes from that lineage. And we feel like the world's at a really interesting place right now where we're doing a lot of empowerment, specifically female empowerment. And also at a time where everybody's stuck at home, so we're discovering alternative art, movies, and music. Like, we're kind of checking out some of our history on some of the things that we dig. And additionally, women like Tura also paved the way for countless other women to harness the power of sexuality and femininity at the same time. And also, like, her story is the story that superheroes are born of. So check this out. Tura was born in Hokkaido, Japan, and her family moved to the U.S. in 1942, where her family spent 2 years in an internment camp. Her family after that then settled in Chicago, and at a young age, Tura was raped by a gang of men. Her father responded to the attacks by training her in Aikido and karate, and over the next 15 years, Tura extracted her revenge on each of the assailants? Anyway, tell me that isn't some superhero storyline badass stuff right there. Tura was actually her real name. You know, that sounds like a stage name that any one of us would make up, but that was her real name. She moved to Los Angeles from Chicago at 17. She started dating Elvis Presley. She dated Frank Sinatra, and when Russ Meyer spotted her, he immediately cast her for the now legendary cult film Faster Pussycat Kill Kill. Once she was cast, Tura acted out all of her own stunts, performing every single jab, stab. I mean, the fact that she learned Aikido and karate from her dad also helped her, you know, pummel these dudes in this movie. Besides Faster Pussycat Kill Kill, Tura acted in two more movies, one of which was Astro-Zombies, which of course has a soft spot in my heart, and I hope yours too. She also survived a gunshot to the stomach from an ex-boyfriend. Again, the superhero parallels of Tura are just crazy, you know? She gets shot, survives it, performs all of her stunts, is a total vigilante with these guys that raped her when she was a kid. She crafted and created the image that has now been copied by countless punk rock and alternative women for decades. She took that Betty Page type aesthetic, added her trademark cat eyeliner, and she did it badder and meaner than anybody else. So, need I say any more about how freaking cool Tura Satana is? And put it bluntly, she's just cool as hell. So, we have some cool contests running this week. Everyone be safe, be nice to each other, damn it, and look out for the Wheel of Terror for our Tura Satana contest this weekend. Hope everybody has a great week. Enjoy your Tura Satana coffee. Check out Faster Pussycat Kill Kill, check out Astro Zombies, and listen to some White Zombie while you're at it. I think that would be a good one.